Drop my guts, the world is us, so what? Who in the
stopping in it. Look, salute when you see me. I bought her a CC and that was her purse. Disgusting what do for a purse. Disgusting what do for the clout. I'm one of the realest. The real ones could vouch. They thought I was done, but all I doubt. You gotta play my next around. Salute when you see me. Put in the car to the my runner gets you speedy. Still thugging like the days when they weren't hearing my CD. Made it out of the trenches. Yeah, salute when you see me. Yeah. Salute when you see me. I'm getting greedy, I blow the whole budget on me, that's on me, I'm conceited. Treaty, nah, that ain't how we treat it. This right here sound like a three-peat. I put the dip in, it sound like I'm knee-deep. I'm like, oh, you too needy. Me and HB going Juvie and BG. They gotta put my face on the box of Wheaties. I'm praying for whoever think they compete. Salute when you see me. That's all he ever, so that's how you greet me. I'm going TM101 cheesy. And plus they got D2 on repeat. I'm with the love of my life for like 3 weeks, cause that's all I needed. She wanna go on a trip or retreat, but I'm sorry, I never retreated. I set the bar so high that you might as well leave it. I'm going undefeated, I've broken the system. Had to breach it, that's mission impossible, mission completed.
Salute when you see me, yeah. I got the heart of a god and a genie. I want you to love me, I want you to need me. When I this face and feed you. I gotta get back to the hood, I remember when I was the needy. Clean me up, squeaky. She fell in love, deeply. They like what I say, they repeat me. Hey, hey, yeah, hey. Look.
Today, from AT&T Stadium in Arlington, Texas, it's week 8 of the NFL on EA Sports. The Dallas Cowboys taking on the Seattle Seahawks.
Just a gorgeous fall afternoon in the heart of Texas. No weather to speak of. Sun out, roof open. Yes, yes, and yes. A great day for football at AT&T Stadium in Arlington. Obviously, they do everything big here in Dallas, and the introduction to the Cowboys, no exception. They're set for football in Big D, as their guys will do battle with the Seattle Seahawks. With Charles Davis, as always, I'm Brandon Gauden. Charles, you talk about storylines in this one. I think it begins and ends with our two quarterbacks, certainly two of the best in the business.
And nowadays, I don't think you get by for long periods of time without a top-flight quarterback. The way the game is played, with all the responsibility he has and how the game flows through him, if he's not on the top of his game, your team's not going to benefit at all.
So here are the Cowboys now ready to go on offense for the first time. And we get a glance here at their leader, the man who will be calling the plays under center.
And what's a quarterback's best friend?
Balance?
I think you're right. I agree with you. You know, a lot of guys would say great receiver, right? A terrific offensive line. But I agree with you, balance, because if you can run the ball effectively, that just opens things up for guys who want to throw it and gives you easier passing lanes and easier coverages to read.
And they said balance will be a focus in this one.
Yeah, they don't want it all just heaped on his shoulders, I don't believe. I think they want to make sure they take some of the pressure off.
Second down, Elliott once more. Two runs in a row, but only 2 yards to show for it. Now you and I, partner, we got the plum assignment this week, an unbeaten team against a one-loss team. Really not much separating these two entering play here today.
Not much at all, and I think for both coaches, they've looked at their team and said, guys, you got to know what you're getting into in this one, and you better be ready to go because you get to answer the big question of the day. Are we as good as we think we are? We're about to find out.
And he's going to have the first down, yardage to the 35. With nowhere to throw it, decided to scramble, and a nice job, CD. Got the yardage that he needed.
Yeah, and his teammates are certainly going to appreciate that effort, even if his coaches don't, because they would have wanted him to slide and protect himself. But he chose team gain over personal protection.
Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. Now they'll switch it up here and look to throw. And this one quickly to Lamb. And he gets this one to midfield before he's brought down. Field strike, they'll look to throw. And it's incomplete. Boy, he doesn't drop many like that one. Second down. And second and 10, he'll look to throw again. Man open, that's complete to Dalton Schultz. 9 yards, and that leaves him just short, so it'll be third and less than a yard. A handoff left, Elliott. And he's able to get the first before he's taken down at the 36. And after getting tackled, he's still down and looking very slow to get up. Well, he gets attended to. We'll step aside. First carry now. This is Williams. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little game. That time, the right guard sending him backwards.
And so many different types of guys rotate in on the defensive line now, depending on situations. You can get the bulky guy, the fast guy. No matter what, though, you can't hold him.
Cooper with a nice grab. And he's going to get this down near the 20-yard line.
I have no crystal ball up here. I can't truly see into the future. But if they don't start getting some pressure on him, make him move around a little bit and do something with the receivers to, you know, change up their timing, they're going to get shredded as we've seen so far. Right now, they're off to a blazing start.
Yeah, and you are right. He looks way too comfortable back there in the pocket.
Yeah, there shouldn't be a pillow back there for him, all right? If as a defensive guy, they've got to dump him on his backside a few times, shake things up.
Yeah, they're going to need an in-drive adjustment here on this first series. And he will slide to a halt at the end of that one.
To give credit to him for buying time and extending the play. But you know, there's some really upset defenders on that one. They thought that they had him. Instead, he was coated in Teflon and got away.
counting down toward the midway point in quarter one. On first and 10, Cherry eluding the pressure right. And he's able to break out of one tackle, but then quickly brought down. Give him a couple on the scramble. It's second down.
He was able to get away earlier in the drive, but apparently all the time they put in practice finally came to the front, didn't it? They remembered their lessons and found a way to contain him when he took off on that one.
Now a second down throw for the end zone, but it's incomplete. The 13th play now coming on this opening drive. Here's third down. On the move to his left. And he is going to go down. Back at the 11-yard line. It'll be a sack and a loss of three, but more importantly, it brings up fourth down.
Well, competition comes up in so many different ways. And right now, this unit, their competition is who's going to get to the quarterback the most times. Had about five sacks last week, and we just saw their first one of this game.
And forthcoming, a field goal try for the Cowboys. And his kick is right there. It's good. And the Cowboys are going to jump out to a 3-0 lead. Well, after marching down the field, only getting three there, kind of feels like a win for the defense.
And it does. They'll go to the sideline feeling a lot better that they didn't give up a touchdown after the march against them.
Now a hit and a loose football. It's picked up by the Cowboys. And this one will be brought back to the 22. And careless with a football there on the kick return.
And one thing I love about going to practices is trying to get around coaches and hear their catchphrases and what they really emphasize. We haven't been to a single one yet this year where a guy fielding a kick, you don't hear, tuck it away, tuck it away, tuck it away. And this time, they turned it over.
Ball security eluded him. On first down, Cherry. And a quick throw here, that's complete. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down. Looking to throw, Cherry. And he's gonna go down. He's sacked back in the 24. Darryl Taylor coming in hard there on the blitz, and he gets him 7 yards behind the line of scrimmage.
Well, the pass rush has been a real strength of late. They know how to get after the quarterback.
Absolutely. Four sacks last week. That's their first one here. Anything in particular you've seen from them or on film?
I think that they're winning athletically up front, winning those one-on-one battles, but also when the offensive line wants to keep everyone in and mass protect, they know how to scheme their way back to the quarterback as well.
The chance of wasting this great starting field position, a real threat. This is third and long. He'll buy some time. And the pressure gets to him again. Darryl Taylor able to get in there for his second sack of the afternoon.
Well, it's about how teams are so competitively matched, and you just want to make those plays that give you an advantage. How about right here? The difference between letting them score a touchdown versus holding them to a field goal? That's absolutely huge with the play he just made.
And you know he hated taking the loss there on third down. So out comes the field goal team now for the second time here today. He hit his first one, this from 44 yards out now. And his kick is indeed good. And that'll make it 6-0 here in the first. So scores on their first two possessions, but 6-0, so field goals probably not what they were hoping for.
Man, you're exactly right about that. Not what they were hoping for, but they should be happy that they have points on the board. It almost feels like that old slow and steady wins the race, doesn't it? In this case, though, they want to be slow and steady now, but get explosive later and put the points up on the board.
Seattle's first go on offense forthcoming, and under center, of course, Russell Wilson.
When I was watching film this week, I had to write a note to myself. 3 touchdown passes in an NFL game deserves respect, not ho-hum just because they throw it around all the time. And he got his respect, NFC Offensive Player of the Week.
Yeah, it's the ultimate vote of confidence from a week ago. Hey, look, he was great, not his best game ever, but obviously was very good to garner that award. All the talk this week, though, was about, let's take that forward now. Officially, it's a 1-yard loss. That's going to bring up 2nd and 11.
This defense is a difficult one to prepare for, one of the best in the league. They'll come at you from all angles, and they did a nice job there stopping him for a loss.
A loss of a yard there to start out. That leads to a 2nd and 11. Throwing is Wilson. It's a short one here, complete to his tight end. And he'll be out of bounds across the 30-yard line.
Defensively here, you're facing a top-5 team in terms of points scored in the NFL. So when they're that high-powered, you've got to find a way to hold them under 20. Because to me, that's the magic number. 20 points scored, give yourself your best chance to win.
So if they're up around 24, 28, 30, they could be in some trouble.
And I think so, because then you turn it into a shootout. And that means your offense has to keep pace.
Nothing, our score after one. On 1st and 10, it's Wilson. And he'll be taken down across the 50 at the 45 in enemy territory.
One of the selling points at the end route is against the quarterback, a really nice sight line to his receiver, and almost on a direct shot, able to throw the ball into the middle of the field and have a great chance of success, as they did on that play.
So from Cowboy territory now, here's 1st and 10 at the 45-yard line. From the shotgun, Wilson. It's a short one here, complete to the tight end. They'll contain him to just 4. 2nd down. Out of the gun, here's Wilson. And they will not get the connection there. It's incomplete. And they'll need to get to the 35 if they want to keep this drive going on 3rd down. Now Wilson. Oh, into a sea of defenders, had intercepted. Picked off by Kelvin Joseph. And the Cowboys are going to take over once again at their own 37-yard line. That throw, Charles, over the middle of the field, and a few too many bodies in there got picked.
That's a normal situation too, isn't it? No matter how hard you try and spread the field sometimes, there's always going to be a traffic jam, it feels like, towards the middle. And if there's any type of a missed throw, or maybe the ball's tipped, or just too many bodies in the area, an interception can result.
The drive will start with an option going left. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. I tell you, there is no antidote for speed, even at the quarterback position, as he keeps it himself and turns it into good yardage.
And it still takes time for a defender to react, even as quarterbacks carry the ball more and more in today's NFL. They're still a little bit in disbelief and realize, oh my goodness, he's running with the ball. He may be 8, 10, 12 yards downfield at that point.
throwing on first down. Cherry, flush to his right. And this will leave him a yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on first down. On second down, Elliott. And they'll be inside the 35 now at the 34-yard line. So a nice run right there. And worth mentioning, their usual starting running back out this week. The hope is it's just a short-term absence. But this is where it pays, Charles, to have a quality reserve that you can turn to when you need it.
And to me, they definitely have that, because this is a guy who's more than capable of picking up the slack. And he's likely going to see a big share of carries as this one progresses. And how many times do we see running backs jump into the breach and have big games?
On first and 10, Cherry, he finds his man complete. It's Schultz, and he'll be pulled down. And now a late flag will come with it. And that's in the area of a face mask, I think. So the hand got inside the face mask that time. Looked like a pretty easy call.
And it was, and we saw this in their loss last week. Penalties at inopportune times that led to their demise.
So now factoring in the face mask, here's first and 10. Back to throw. Cherry, they'll set up the screen to Elliott. And now they're inside the 10 as he's brought down at the 9. This is a 2nd and 4, ball at the 9. From the gun, Cherry. Rick Hitter here, it's complete. And the Cowboys are going to have a 1st and goal coming up as the tackle made at the 3-yard line. Looking to throw, Cherry. Toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete. 3 red zone trips have yielded just 2 field goals for them to this point, so they'll be searching for something more on 2nd and goal here. Elliott is in. Touchdown, Dallas.
I wonder if he changed anything on his play sheet or they just executed better, because they had 2 previous drives that ended in field goals. Before this one, they finally were able to put into the end zone.
Well, whatever he did, speaking of the offensive coordinator, might be using that formula going forward. It worked there.
Yeah, it worked very well. He and his field general in pretty good sync right now. They're starting to move the ball well.
Out comes the kicking team here for the extra point. And he's got it to make it now 13-0. So this drive spans 7 plays, and it culminates in a touchdown run by Ezekiel Elliott. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. And not willing to risk another fumble, he'll sit on this one. It's a touchback. Seattle's offense coming back onto the field, ready for their 2nd drive. And there are parts of their last drive they'd like to emulate. And, of course, they'd like to forget the ending, the interception. But they did put together, Charles, a nice sustained drive to get him down the field.
Yeah, and unfortunately for them, the only thing that matters is part two, right? Because once they threw the interception and finished off the drive, that does them no good to go back and say, well, you know, we had a good one going. Finish things off. That's the only way you can get it done.
Throwing again on 2nd and 10. Wilson, and the catch is made here by Tyler Lockett. And this will be a gain of 5 as he gets it to the 30.
When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go, because he might wander into some tough coverage.
Here's Wilson. Open man is Metcalf. He's got it. And he is going to have a Seahawks 1st down as they're able to get the 3rd down conversion.
And that's understanding where the markers are, because it's not just running to them. Because on the catch, you can actually be pushed back before the 1st down. It's getting past it and allowing that opportunity to drift back towards the 1st down line and still having picked it up. Really well run.
They'll run on 1st down.
Carson.
And he's going to take this ahead for right around 3 yards, but no more than that. Second down. On second and 7, Wilson. He'll find Metcalf. So from Cowboy territory now, here's first and 10 at the 49-yard line. The throw down the field, caught by his running back. And down to the 20 he'll go before heading out of bounds. An inaugural trip to the red zone here for the Seahawks. First and 10 right at the 20. There's Wilson to throw. Got his man complete over the middle. It's Carson. And the Seahawks are going to have a first and goal as the tackle made at the 10-yard line. They'll throw on first down with Wilson. Toward the back corner of the end zone, but he could not get the feet down. This will wind up incomplete.
To this point, I've been impressed with the work defensively. They have not allowed a lot of receivers to run free. And there's another example, another incompletion.
On second and goal, Wilson. And that falls to the ground, incomplete. A nice job of bodying him up defensively. And now it brings up third down. On third and goal, Wilson. And that's incomplete. The free safety, Malik Hooker, there in coverage. Rosas' kick is good. And they will indeed get on the board here, but still trailing. It's now 13-3. Maybe a moral victory of sorts. They're on the board here late in the first half, but this offense just hasn't looked that sharp.
Yeah, but at least they got the 3 points, right? At least they have something to, quote-unquote, hang their hats on and maybe feel a little bit better about themselves as they head to the half.
Now out comes their leader and the captain of this offense back onto the field. And maybe he's starting to wave the white flag a little bit. He's playing pretty well, but the pressure, it's got to him.
Has to find a way to step around it, step through it, or just handle it. Because as you mentioned, he's having a pretty good day overall. Just the hits keep coming and taking those sacks. That's not the way that they want to finish a ball game with their quarterback on the ground so much.
He'd like to stay upright. When he's been upright, he's been pretty good. Now the Cowboys going to burn the first of their timeouts as the stoppage will come with a little under a minute to go in this first half. To throw on second down, Cherry, he finds his man, complete. That's Schultz. The Cowboys going to use their second timeout now as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds to go in the first half. On first down, Cherry looking for Cooper. That's complete. And a 5-yard gain gets him to the 42. Second down at 5. Back to throw again. And he'll slide to a halt here, still a little shy of the first down marker. A final shot before break. Cherry, and that's going to be incomplete. The coverage too good there. The contact popped the ball free, and it's fourth down. So we have come to halftime here in Dallas with the Cowboys out in front as we send you on over to Orlando for Jonathan Coachman in our EA Sports Halftime Report. Take it away, Coach.
All right, Brandon, thanks very much. Hi again, everybody. Let's get you caught up with what's going on around the league here in the unofficial midway point. Week 8 of the NFL season. We'll start our tour out in the City of Angels, Los Angeles. And it's the football team who have the lead in that one. Will Fuller, a touchdown reception. From there, let's head to the foot of the Rockies, Denver, Colorado, to check in on the Broncos. And they trail in that one to the visiting Las Vegas Raiders. Derek Carr has a couple of touchdown passes there. Finally, let's get to Philadelphia. Check on the Eagles at home at Lincoln Financial Field. And they were winners in that one over the visiting New York Giants. Jalen Hurts leading the way in the victory with 3 touchdown passes. Meanwhile, in our game, it's been a back-and-forth first half. Who can put it together in the second half? For the answer, we turn it back over to our broadcast team of Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
All right, Coach, thank you very much as we welcome you back for quarter number 3. The Seahawks trailing, but they will have possession first here as we resume action in the third quarter. Tyler Lockett now with a return. And the tackle going to be made right there at the 25-yard line. The Seahawk offense set to go to begin this third quarter. And they're still very much in this game, although they do trail. What's the game plan, Charles, for the second half?
It might be a little counterintuitive because most people will think losing equals passing the ball more, but I'd establish the running game. They kind of went away from it in the first half. I think if they get back in balance, it'll help them when they put the ball back in the air.
And he'll wind up with about 6, up past the 30 to the 31. They'll come up now 2nd and 4 from the 31. From the gun, it's Wilson. And the Cowboys' pressure gets there this time for the sack. Jeffrey Simmons in there to get him, and that is sack number 6 now for him on the year.
I'd say it's not panic time yet, but let's be honest about it. Empty possession here, not what you're looking for when you're down a couple of scores.
Absolutely not. Trying to start the second half off on the right foot. Unfortunately, going to give the ball up. Wilson of the Seahawks looking for something big following the sack. It's 3rd and long here. Now it's Wilson. That's incomplete, but there is a flag down. So hang on, a big call coming on 3rd down. So instead of giving them another 3rd down, they'll decline it, brings up 4.
Now that's smart football right there. You don't even have to really spend a lot of time considering it. Just know that you're probably going to get the ball back. Good job declining that penalty.
Great coverage there. Holds him to a 2-yard return following a 50-yard punt. And possession will switch hands, 1st and 10. So here are the Cowboys to take over. They've got the lead right now. And remember, they are riding that very impressive 7-game winning streak, trying to push it to 8. They'll start the drive with Elliott. And from the 25, they work this to the 29, a gain of 4. And they'll work from the 29 on 2nd and 6. They go to Elliott again. It's a 5-yard gain, but they'll still be a yard short here with 3rd down now looming. In the first half, he was held in check on the ground, but despite that lack of production, they still have the lead.
Yeah, and they've got to feel fortunate about that. If they could actually get production from their lead horse, that would help open up this offense and widen this margin, too.
Yeah, Elliott trying to work his way forward, but it looks like he did not make it. No gain on the play there, and it'll bring up 4th down.
He continues to struggle to find a crease to break off a big one. It might need to just put that aside and just try and ram his way forward and get what he can.
Comes the Cowboys punter. And the way this offense has moved the ball, he hasn't been needed till here in the third. He only punted twice in the win last week as he gets this one away. Returnable for Lockett. 7 yards on the return after a punt of 39. And it'll be Seahawk football, 1st and 10. And we will get another look at Seattle's offense. And our game's hit a little bit of a lull here, a little bit of a snag. Punts on back-to-back drives.
And old-school coaches don't necessarily mind that. Didn't turn it over, right? Didn't create a big play for the other team. Right now, what you're looking for
is can you gain an advantage in field position? And that's what both teams are seeking right now.
Yeah, they'll be seeking to gain that advantage here on this drive.
But we can talk about it like it's just a basic route, but how about the timing on this one? Lined up on the right, runs a deep in route, and how about the throw? Right on the money. Bam, puts it right in there and on his hands. Nice completion, really good pickup.
From midfield now, here's Wilson. It's a short one here, complete to his tight end. They'll contain him to just four, second down.
Completion was given up, but that's why you play zone defense, so that you can have people around the ball when it's caught, and you don't give up much run after the catch.
6 yards left on second down. To throw is Wilson. Throw left side, complete. That's Fox. Short completion, just 4 yards. And that'll lead here to a third down. Wilson after the play fake to Carson. Over the middle, that's caught by Metcalf. And he's going to have the first down yardage to the 35.
Well, this might very well have been four down territory, but that's not going to matter now. They get a nice throw there on third down, and they're able to keep the drive going.
Still in search of their first touchdown of the game, but they're on the move, first and 10. Now it's Carson. Call it a gain of four on first, and that'll make it second down. Wilson. This one complete to his fullback out of the backfield. So now we have Jackson slow to get back on his feet. Appears to be shaken up. While the training staff works on him, we'll step aside and be right back. On first down, Carson. He's able to work free for about 6 down to the 18. 6 yards on that last play. Here's second and 4. They stay on the ground. Again, it's Carson. And this has been a familiar sight all afternoon as they stop him behind the line. A loss on that play, and now third down gets tougher. 3rd and 6.
We've seen this a few times in this game. That offensive line just, I don't know if you want to call it out physical, out tough, whatever you want to use.
And what people do when that is happening, when they're getting dominated that way, they spread things out a little bit, make it more of a space game, and allow your skill position players to make a few plays out in open field. Take away the physical element, gives you a chance.
And this pass broken up. And the contact well timed there, and now 4th down. Rosas' kick is good, and they will cut the lead back down to a touchdown now at 13-6. So 3 points, maybe not a grand prize at this stage, but it does get them back within one score.
It certainly does, because now they stay within shouting distance, so that means everyone on your sideline stays engaged in this game. They know they still have a shot.
Now Dallas gets set to take the field. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
Runs through the contact, and he's upended at the 33, following a good pickup of 8. Here's a 2nd and 2 now from the 33. Again, it's Elliott.
But we always always talk about good down and distance allowing offenses to expand their playbook. Well, second and two, that means your playbook's wide open. You can run just about anything. But a lot of times, the play caller, he just looks down at his sheet, sees the short yardage runs, and goes to one of those.
Three quarters have come and gone. This is the National Football League on EA Sports. On second down, it's Elliott. 5 yards, now it's third and five. Back to throw, Cherry, and that's Elliott complete. And he is going to lose yardage here. They'll wind up losing a yard on the play, and it'll be fourth down. I hate to surrender the football when you're nursing a slim lead, but they're going to have to punt it away. Trust that defense.
It's the right play at this stage of the game as well. You don't need to press it here because you do have that little bit of a cushion, and you count on your D to make it stand up.
Out now comes the Cowboys punter as he's on here to punt it away. That'll be a 43-yard punt, but a net of just 33 following a 10-yard return. Defensively, you said coming in earlier in the broadcast, a magic number was 20 points for you. That's what you thought they would have to hold this offense to, or less than that. And wow, they've done that in a big way, haven't they?
Not only have they done it, they put themselves in a great position to win this one because holding them down was paramount. If they could get it done, well, guess what? We see the end result. Right now, they have their eye on victory.
And leading here in the fourth. And that one off the mark behind him, incomplete. The intended receiver was DK Metcalf. And that'll bring up second down. Now it's Wilson. A Lockett with a grab over the middle. And they're able to get this one across the 35. On first down, Wilson. He finds his man complete. It's Fox. It'll be a gain of five, and it'll be second down. Wilson. He finds his man complete. It's Fox. The drive continues as they search for a tying touchdown. Here's first and 10. Here's Wilson. And he will go down. Cowboys sack. Matt Ioannidis able to record his fifth sack of the season.
It seemed like he kept going through those progressions, and I thought he might dump that underneath, but he couldn't get rid of the football in time.
And I have to wonder if he was thinking while he was back there, I wish there were a lot less progressions on this play, just someone that I could dump the ball to and get it out of my hands.
Another try after the first down sack. Wilson, this complete to Lockett. That catch good for five. It's third down. Now Wilson. And this is going to be incomplete.
Certainly appeared to take away his first read, and by the time he tried to look elsewhere and find an open target, the coverage was too good. That one falls incomplete.
And on fourth down, on is the punt team sending this one away. The Dallas offense back out onto the field. They're holding on right now to that slim advantage in a one-score game. And you hear a lot about two-minute offense and four-minute offense. Obviously, the four-minute offense applies here. How do they run that effectively?
Yeah, really what the four-minute offense is you're just trying to grind the clock. So you want consistent gains, steady gains. Doesn't have to be big plays, but it has to be plays that gets first downs and keeps the ball away from your opponent.
But certainly throwing the ball is in the mix here.
It certainly is. Just make sure that you're careful with it. And again, get those first downs, keep possession of the football.
There's a ball thrown right side and complete. And he's able to get this to the 40-yard line before he's out of bounds.
And these guys certainly are not hiding what their intention is. They're absolutely showing it. They're definitely not going to sit on this lead here in the fourth quarter.
So signs of life in what's been a dormant offense in this second half. Here's first and 10. Looking to throw. Cherry, and he finds his target. It's Schultz. A gain of 6 there on first.
They gave up the completion there, but this is what zone defenses count on. Catching the ball and not much run after the catch.
From the 35, back to work on second and 4. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And he works it to the 30-yard line here, right at the 30. Now after the running play, we've got a man down on the field. While the training staff takes a peek, we'll take a break. So first and 10 now from the 30. Back to throw. Cherry shoves him aside. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little gain. Coming up to the line, and they will need to run another play here before the two-minute warning. On second down now, it's Elliott. And they'll bring him down at the 18-yard line. Fourth quarter, down to the final 2 minutes, and we've got a one-score game. So the Cowboys in possession of the football here as we get you reset. They've got a first and 10 as they look to try and finish this one off. Here's Elliott. And he'll get him inside the 15 down to the 14-yard line. And now right out of the two-minute break, we'll get a timeout used defensively with a minute 56 to go. They go back to Elliott. He's been busy. And now they're inside the 10 as he's brought down at the 9. And now with 1:52 to go, we get another pause in the action. A timeout here defensively. This will be play number 8 here on the drive. It's 3rd and 1 yard. Out of the gun, it's Elliott. And he's going to run into a brick wall right in the middle of the field, and I don't think he got there. Now the Seahawks forced to use their 3rd and final timeout as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. And his kick is good. And that one makes this a 10-point game at 16-6. So that one, CD, going to make the road back a lot more difficult.
Oh, there's no doubt about that. You know they were praying on the other sideline for a miss because now, as you pointed out, a very difficult road. Down 2 scores. You don't just need a touchdown. You need a chain of events to go your way. You've got to score, somehow get the ball back, and score again. The odds of that happening, not great in your favor.
So Wilson and the Seahawks down by 10, a minute 45 to play. They've won 3 in a row, but they've got work to do if they want to get a 4th in a row as they come up on first down. Wilson's throw taken in by Adams. Throwing now is Wilson. Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Fox. Wilson trying to urge his guys to go faster and get set at the line. And the Cowboys' pressure gets there this time for the sack. They'll get to the line here, but remember, it's also 3rd down. And that's complete to Adams. And he is going to have a Seahawks 1st down as they're able to get the 3rd down conversion. Looking deep for Adams. And that's going to wind up incomplete. However, we do have a flag down. Let's check in with our referee. Now a chance to make that big play really hurt. It's 1st and goal just outside the 5. Now Wilson. Throw left side complete. That's Fox. They'll contain him to just four. Second down. One last shot for Wilson. And they're going to get him. They bring him down to the sack back at the 16-yard line. So this one will end in a victory for the Dallas Cowboys, and they were spurred on by a strong performance in that fourth quarter as they held their opponents off the scoreboard.
Everyone wants to pitch a shutout for the entire game, but when you throw one in the fourth quarter, that tells everyone that you're getting stronger and dominance is starting to take over, right? The way that you close, the way that you finish, that gets preached to you from the time you're playing Little League football all the way up through. And they closed them out with a big-time performance down the stretch.
So for the Cowboys, they continue to cruise as they move to 8-0 now on the campaign. And they'll have another home date next week as the Carolina Panthers come to town. Meanwhile, for the Seahawks, the loss will drop them to 6-2 now on the year. And they'll get a chance to redeem themselves next week at home against San Francisco. So for Charles Davis and our entire crew, I'm Brandon Gaudin. Next game, guess what? Charles and I will be here again. It's the NFL on EA Sports.
Cash money, yeah, baby, I'm a stunner. I'm a boss, I can do what I wanna. Your last was a dude, boy, that wasn't running. Made it to the top floor, but we started from the gutter. Shot him to the moon, we ain't never going under. Hits on hits, I'm a old town slugger. Why after why, we ain't never got herself. Made it to the top floor, but we started from the gutter. Stunned like no one stunner. She curved me back then, came back, so I swung her. I ain't going out like no sucker. Had to let it burn like Usher. Gave a rush for an hour, Chris Tucker. You can never stay me for another. I had to wait my time like a buffer. I'm that did I stutter. Ball hard, might get a tick. Bought a push start for it, got a check. Drip too hard, made it. I know she won't.